Years ago, I recognized my kinship with all living things. I made up my mind that I was not one bit better than the meanest on the earth. I said then, and I say now, that while there's a lure fast, I am in it. While there's a criminal element, I am of it. While there's a soul in prison, I am not free. That was written by Eugene Debs, an American labor and political leader. After working for over 30 years in the Ontario Public Service, enduring an emotionally damaging institutional closure, going back to school after 50, and the loss of my mother to Alzheimer's, my daughter to cancer, I moved to St. Thomas, and a failed job opportunity, I found myself in a very difficult spot in our economically depressed city, with very limited job options for someone over 55. Over time, I was faced with the reality that we were in a position where we had no food, limited income, and bills to pay. Have you ever been to a mission or soup kitchen? Have you ever been to a food bank? Well, neither I. Until the early last summer, we fell through the cracks of the system. No more employment insurance, just enough money for no social assistance, and not enough money to get by. Fortunately, I found a privately operated food bank that was willing to help us out. We discovered the Grace Cafe, Mission and Soup Kitchen, Community Fellowship Meals Program, and with some help with some very long-term friends, we managed to get by. A really good quote that I came across today is, "Damned is the man who abandons himself." These six words show that the worse the situation is, never should a man consider it lost. And that was written by a guy that he calls himself The Condition. Even after spending many years working with vulnerable clients in the psychiatric hospital, the youth and adult correction systems, I was blind to the reality of what really happens on the street. I certainly saw the results of poverty through our increased incarceration of adults and youth. I became aware that we, the people working in the system, had no idea what people in poverty actually deal with every day. Generational poverty wasn't even on my radar, and people suffering from poverty because of displacement from other countries were never a consideration. We were never trained in what poverty really looked like and what it meant to our clients. As part of my walk, I had the good fortune of attending the Bridges Out of Poverty workshop, courtesy of Goodwill Industries in London. What an eye-opener. Have you ever been placed in a situation where you only had two bad choices? Think of reporting for jail for a three-day sentence and leaving your preteen children at home to fend for themselves. What would your choice be? Who would you call when your car broke down on the road? CAA, the garage, versus Uncle Joe, Dad, or buddy down the street? Tough choices when you have very limited income and you still have to get to your minimum wage job. Even though I don't represent the program, I love Bridges Out of Poverty. It's a fabulous program that helps people living in poverty negotiate their way through the system. A system designed, administered, and operated by middle-class people. A language that people living in poverty do not understand. It really changed my perspective on a lot of things, and I saw a different light when I went through that program. I've observed that there is often a disconnection between middle class and those living in poverty that is difficult to understand for those of us without lived experience on both sides of that divide. I can see a need to include those with lived experience in poverty in the discussion and design of poverty programs to address poverty. We have many in our community who are stuck in the system with minimum wage jobs, employment agencies, and predatory lenders all waiting to exploit them, our working poor. Many more are walking the razor's edge. They are one accident, one illness, or tragedy of any type from going over the edge. Are you one? Could you be next? Despite the fact that poverty is mostly invisible in our community, it clearly exists on many levels. We have many supports in our community. We need to celebrate them and make them more accessible. I challenge you, I mean every one of you, to find out what is needed in our community to help out Bridges Out of Poverty, the Circles Program, the Grace Cafe, In Out of the Cold, the Talbot Teen Center, the Community Fellowship Meals Program, and any other program that you know you can help. Help make program information easily accessible to all that need it. And most of all, we need to encourage the mayor, council, and other levels of government to tear down the barriers. Engage people with lived experience in poverty. Learn from them. And turn the page on historical hostility towards those really in need.